closely monitored for any post-surgery complications, but all of the rooms are full. What's our protocol to find this patient another room? They need to be monitored for the next 2 days. I'm not sure. Let me ask Owen. Owen, what do I do when all of the rooms are full on the third floor, but the patient still needs to be closely monitored? Their status is still too severe to put them on the second floor because we don't have that staffed for the type of follow-up this patient needs, but they're stable enough that they no longer need to be in the recovery unit, and we need to free up that bed. I'm not going to just tell you what the answer is, but I will help you figure it out. When you need to make a decision and you're unsure of the answer, these are some steps I like to follow to help me come up with the best decision. 3. How do I start? What is the first step? First, ask yourself, what is the problem? The patient needs to be closely monitored for possible complications from surgery, but they don't have any rooms available on the third floor to move him to where he could be monitored 24 hours a day. Okay, are there any additional details or criteria to the problem that could help determine a solution? Well, the patient does not currently have any friends or family that are here, so when a nurse or doctor isn't able to watch over him, he would be alone. Now that you know the details of the problem, what are your options? We could leave him in the recovery unit where nurses are there 24 hours a day. The other option is the first floor for non-critical patients waiting release. So now, evaluate your options. What are the advantages and disadvantages? The recovery unit would have 24-hour monitoring, but only has nurses trained for post-surgical procedures to prepare the patient to be moved to their designated rooms, and there are no doctors easily accessible in that room. The first floor has 2 doctors assigned to the patients. However, the nurses only check on the patient once every 2 hours. They also work short shifts, so the rotation of nurses would constantly be new nurses that are not familiar with this condition. Which do you think is the best option? Or can you think of something you can do to improve one of those options? I will move him to the first floor so we can free up the bed in the recovery unit, but I will assign 2 interns to monitor his condition twice per hour. That's great. And the last thing to do is follow up on your decision and make sure everything is going as planned. I will watch his electronic chart and have the interns report directly his status to me every hour.